A hydraulic lift is used to lift heavy weights by pushing down on a small piston with a diameter of 13 centimeters. The diameter of the large piston on which the mass is to be placed is 1 meter. If the downward force on the lever is P equal to 100 newtons, what is the mass that can be lifted on the platform connected to the large piston? What is the ratio between the input and output force of this hydraulic lift? Assume that the atmospheric pressure on both sides is the same and that the weight of the pistons is negligible. Pause here and try solving this problem yourself before watching the solution. This is the first example for the thermodynamics units and basic pressure 11-minute lecture video. The links to the other examples on this topic and the other lectures of the THERMO course are found in the description below. Since what we want to find is the weight on the larger piston that we can lift when applying a 100 newton force on the lever, let's begin with a free body diagram of that piston. We have the weight of the mass going down and the force caused by the pressure going up. From the main lecture video, we determined that this force is equal to the pressure inside the cylinder, which is the pressure of the fluid, times the area of the piston. We could add the force caused by the atmospheric pressure on the piston, but since it was established that both pistons are subjected to atmospheric pressure, these two forces can be disregarded. More on that in just a second. Also, because the weights of the piston are negligible, we don't add that weight here. From this expression, we realize that we can calculate the area with the given diameter information, but we still need to find the pressure in the fluid. To do this, we draw a free body diagram of the smaller piston. The piston is subjected to the force that the lever generates at B, going down, and the force caused by the pressure going up. In this case, the area refers to that of the smaller piston. Again, we can add the force caused by the atmospheric pressure going down, but we'll see soon enough that it would cancel out with the atmospheric pressure force on the other piston. The force that the lever causes on the piston can be easily found with a free body diagram of the lever itself. We have the reaction force from the piston on the lever going up, the external force that is being applied going down, and some vertical reaction force at the hinge. We don't care about this force though, because with a sum of moments about the hinge C, we find that the force going into the piston is 600 newtons. Since the pressures at 1 and 2 are the same, we can solve for P from the smaller piston and substitute it in our first equation to find that the weight is equal to A2 over A1 times the force. Therefore, the weight that can be lifted is about 35.5 kilonewtons and the mass equal to 3,619 kilograms. As for the second question, the ratio between the output force and the input force is the ratio between the weight, which is a force and is the output in this case, over the original external load P. This ratio is therefore equal to roughly 355. If you want to check out the other examples for this same topic, the main lecture video, or other lectures of the THERMO course and other engineering courses, make sure to check out the links in the description below. Thanks for watching!